Well, good morning and welcome, my friends. Welcome. I think I know most of you, but if we haven't had the pleasure yet of meeting, my name is Matt, and it is truly an honor. It's my honor, my privilege, and my blessing to be a part of the celebration of the life. It's such a good life. To be a part of the celebration of the life of Joanna Irene Kennedy. We gather in this sacred and beautiful place. We gather, yes, in so many ways, to pray, to ask for blessing, to say farewell. But primarily, we gather to celebrate life. Yes, to celebrate the love that is Joanna. To celebrate the love that connects us all together, to celebrate life. Joanna's life and our lives together. And my friends, our celebration begins right here at the entrance of the church, at this baptismal font. Miss Carol and all of us bring her beloved Joanna into the sanctuary. We are mindful of God's loving presence. And so, yes, we begin near this baptismal font, asking God's blessing on all of us and asking God's eternal blessing on Joanna Irene Kennedy. So, Carol, I invite you to. The grace and peace of God and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. My dear friends, as we bless our sister's earthly remains with this baptismal water, we remember that in death, Joanna died with Christ. She rose with him to new life. May our dear sister now share with Christ in eternal glory. My friends, sacred scripture tells us over and over again that the Lord is kind and merciful, loving and forgiving. Joanna is now in the hands of this loving God, and we who remain, we hold a sure and certain hope in the promise of the resurrection to life eternal. My friends, thank you so much for being here to celebrate a good and loving woman. Thank you for being here to celebrate Joanna's life. I am so grateful to God for all the hard work. Carol's put so much time, love, and devotion into this special celebration. Carol and Joanna have brought us together to celebrate love. So I'm grateful for the beauty of this day. I'm grateful for the many ways that we strive to bring beauty, the beauty of love into our world. So my friends, let us stand. Please stand and join together in singing our gathering hymn, which speaks so beautifully of how Joanna and Carol live their lives. All are welcome. Indeed, all are welcome, and we begin by signing ourselves with the sign of God's love in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of the Lord, the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends, yes, all are welcome as we gather in this sacred and beautiful place, as we gather to celebrate life. To truly celebrate Joanna's life, to thank God for the days that we had with her, to thank God for the many blessings that she brought to all of us. We gather also to ask God to welcome her home and to comfort our broken hearts. Joanna's life, it was a life well lived, a life filled with passion, with much love and joy, with so many connections, a life filled with so many blessings. Joanna Irene Kennedy is someone who made a difference in so many lives. She was faithful, she was loving, and she was so kind. I know that your lives, our lives, our little corner of the world, are better. Better for knowing her. Yes, this place is better for having her passed through it. And so we pray. We pray on this day, prayers of gratitude, prayers of faith and hope and love, prayers seeking comfort and consolation, prayers to remind all of us that life is it's too short. It goes by so quickly. So we do well to be mindful of the gift of life, the gift of each other, every day. And so we pray. Gracious and loving God, you to whom mercy and forgiveness belong, hear our prayers this day on behalf of your servant, our sister and friend, Joanna, whom you have called out of this world. Joanna put her hope, her trust, and her love in you. We ask that you carry her safely home to heaven, where she may enjoy her eternal reward. This we ask through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. My friends, I invite you to please be seated as we listen to the Word of God.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed, in the view of the foolish, to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace, for if to others indeed they seemed punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. In the time of their visitation, they shall shine and dart about as sparks through the stubble. They shall judge nations and rule over people, and the Lord shall be their king forever. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love. Because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with the elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. A reading from St. Paul's letters to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, if God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but handed him over for us all, will he not also give us everything else along with him? Who will bring a charge against God's chosen ones? It is God who acquits us. Who will condemn? It is Christ Jesus who died, rather was raised, who also is at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us. What will separate us from the love of Christ? Will anguish or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or the sword? No. In all those things we conquer overwhelmingly through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor present things, nor future things, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain. And after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the land. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall be shown mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called the children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. And blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Count your blessings. I can't tell you how many times I've heard that growing up. Coming from a big family, there were many things that maybe we did not have as children that we wanted. We were very quick to pray for the things that we wanted. And my mom and our little bedtime prayers would remind us of how blessed we really were and how much we did have. And so she would always challenge her children to never forget to count your blessings. This woman, Joanna Irene Kennedy, this beautiful, joyful woman whom we gather in this place to celebrate, she was good at counting her blessings. She would look around this room right here, right now, and she would see in every one of your faces, I can imagine her gazing into your eyes and saying, in her own ways, what an amazing blessing are all of you. Now, the Beatitudes, that book, that reading from Matthew's Gospel, that beautiful reading that Carol chose, speaks of blessings. Even in moments that don't feel very blessed, well, when we're healthy and grounded in love, when we're safe, secure, happy, we can find blessing, even in the midst of challenge. This is the kind of day, as we grieve and mourn, we're mindful. We're mindful of the beauty of life, the gift of life, and the importance of sharing that gift and sharing that beauty with each other. Now, our first reading from the Book of Wisdom, Kate proclaimed for us that the souls of the just are in God's hands and no torment shall touch them there. There are so many reasons we have such great consolation that Joanna is in God's loving hands. Like, as I read on to speak of like sparks darting about in stubble, their light shall shine. Her light shined. I look at those pictures. I see that gorgeous smile. I see the twinkle in her eyes. Her light shone brightly through her life. And she shared that light from little on up. She shared it generously and freely. There are certain people that just simply being in their presence makes you feel better. I think your Joanna was one of those people. Being with her, you couldn't help but kind of find something to smile or laugh about. Being with her and the ways that she celebrated just the goodness of life, kind of as a good reminder, it is for us right now a good reminder to just do the best we can to celebrate life. For we all know this all too well. The world, there's a lot of darkness in our world. So that makes it even more important that we let our light shine. Shine for all the world to see. So we come to this beautiful place, a place with a great deal of history. And some of the history is very painful. The banner hanging in the back of the room, you might have noticed it when you came in. It's there as a reminder. It's one segment, one section of the National AIDS Memorial Quilt. One little section, 12 feet by 12 feet. It's quite a large piece of fabric, but really just a small reminder of the many lives that have been lost and the many who still struggle and suffer. Joanna supported. She loved, and she did all she could to share her love freely. As we gather in this place where we speak about God's inclusive love being proclaimed, we gather in this place where we strive to go from just proclaiming love to truly living love. She did that well, didn't she, Carol? She lived love. And our reading, our second reading, which George proclaimed for us, reminds us that God, and also in our psalm that Alondra so beautifully sang for us as our cantor, that the Lord is kind and merciful, blessing those who choose to love. From little on up, Joanna chose to love. She chose to make connections and to keep those connections, to keep them strong and secure. So we gather in this place from near and from far. We gather on live stream. We gather because Joanna brings us together. She connects us. She and Carol, they built a beautiful house, a home, a family, that place where, as we sang the song that Carol chose for our opening hymn, a place where all are welcome. So we count our blessings. And I truly believe this, those who are blessed, we have a responsibility. We who are blessed, we have a responsibility to do the best we can to be blessed, to be the blessing that we have received. And our readings today, they speak of the importance of the beauty, the gift of faith and hope, and the greatest of these, love. Love, it's that stuff that can fill our hearts. It can help us to remain hopeful. It can give us strength to face the challenges that life did bring to Joanna, especially in these last couple of years. Love gives us the strength and courage to face the challenges that life inevitably brings to all of us. Yes, I believe it. I know it. Joanna loved deeply. She lived fully. Her life made a difference. And isn't that something I hope, and we all hope, that on our last day, people will look back and say, yes, that life, their life, her life, his life, it made a difference. I believe that our world is a better place. It's a better place for Joanna's presence in it. To open one's heart and to begin to love. That is how Joanna lived life. She and Carol, they always did their best to make sure everyone fit. Everyone felt welcome. Everyone was at home. And so in this place, MHR is our home, we say. This place that we call home, we're mindful, yes, of the importance of hospitality and welcome. I think about home. I think about your home. I think how after Joanna's passing, how your neighbors came to create a shrine, a little place of remembrance, bringing flowers and candles, things to just remember Joanna, things to remember her beauty, the beauty of her garden, the beauty of her life, the light that she was. It's just one small example of, yes, she made a difference. You make a difference. And the two of you made a difference and continue to make a difference together. It was with gladness in his heart that Jesus welcomed Joanna home. In another gospel, kind of one of my favorites in these moments, from John, speaks of, Jesus says, in my Father's house there are many dwelling places, and I am going before to prepare a place for you, so that where I am, you also may be. So you leave at Joanna's home. She's home in a place prepared for her in heaven. And she awaits. She awaits whenever that day may come for that great, beautiful reunion. Be sure, if you haven't had a moment to, just take a moment to, after Mass, maybe to gaze for a moment on this beautiful urn. Joanna, Irene Kennedy, and Carol inscribed these words, "My blessed wife forevermore, in my heart and in my soul, until God joins us together for eternity." Isn't that the beauty of our faith, that we believe that, yes, for Joanna, life has changed, it has not ended. She lives on with all the saints in heaven, and she awaits that beautiful and blessed reunion. So today, my friends, we give thanks. We give thanks to our God who has blessed Joanna. We give thanks to our God for the blessing in our lives that is and always will be Joanna Irene Kennedy. So when we count our blessings, be sure, as will I, be sure to, in that little list, in that little list that could go on and on and on, be sure to count the blessing that is Joanna. Hey, my friends, counting our blessings, let us stand and lift up our prayers, our needs, our hopes, and our dreams. Jesus said to us, "Do not be afraid, for I am with you always." Joanna's faith helped her to believe that there was something greater than this, that there was life beyond death. Let us pray, my friends, to our loving God, with the trust that God hears all of our prayers.
We pray for the repose of the soul of Joanna Irene Kennedy. May her soul be admitted to the company of all the saints. Together, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who mourn Joanna's death, especially family and friends, that they may find strength and consolation in the hope we have through the resurrection of Jesus from the dead. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who care for the ill and the dying. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the church, that may be a beacon of light to the world, serving all people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our nation and our community, that we may set an example to promote peace and hunger, hopelessness and poverty once and for all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our loved ones who have gone before us. Lord, give them the reward of their goodness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all of us here today and for all members of our church, that we may be prepared for the hour of our death, when God will call us by name to pass from this world into the next. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And so we ask our loving God, yes, to hear these prayers we speak aloud, to hear the many prayers we hold in our hearts. Our second reading reminded us that nothing will separate us from God's love. So yes, we turn to our loving God, asking that he would welcome Joanna home. Keep her safe. Welcome her into your kingdom, O Lord, and grant her the fullness of redemption. This and all of our prayers we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My friends, I invite you to please be seated as we prepare for the celebration of the Eucharist.
You shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak.
Pray, my friends, stand and pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. Lord, accept the sacrifice we offer for our dear sister Joanna on this, the day as we celebrate her eternal life. May this offering of peace gain for her a place with all your saints in heaven. We ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ, our Lord and Savior. In him, the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful, O Lord, life is changed but not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, We sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, O Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. And remember, O Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, Salvador, our Bishop, all the clergy, the religious, with your entire people. Remember your servant Joanna, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. And remember also all of our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. And all who have died in your mercy, welcome them, O Lord, into the light of your face. And have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, the martyrs, with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
My friends, it is at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, that we dare to pray in those words that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, O Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always kept free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us share with each other. Oops, I'm sorry. Sorry. Say it again. I don't think we heard you. Say it. He has two lines, and I stole one of his two lines. So say it again so we can hear you. Say it. Takes away the sins of the world, blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
One breath.
Loving God, we pray. We pray for our sister Joanna.
No, just sit down. Sit down.
Loving God, we pray for our sister Joanna, whom you have called from this world. Grant that she will pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace. May this Eucharist cleanse her, assure forgiveness where needed, and raise her up to eternal joy in your presence. We ask through Christ our Lord. Amen. My friends, it is never easy. It is never easy to say goodbye. The beauty of our prayer, our rituals of saying goodbye, our sharing of memories, our simply being together. All of these things help to ease our sadness and help us truly celebrate the good and loving woman, a life well lived. And there are so many stories to be shared. So Carol, I invite you to come forward in giving us a few of those stories, loving remembrance of your beloved wife. Thank you, Carol.
Thank you, Father. I've got a full book, so sit tight. First of all, the gift of music, the spirit of the words, the support through all the service is so graciously and humbly thanked for on behalf of myself and Joanna. It just touches my soul deeply. Everyone here are all friends that just jumped at it when I said, can you be a part of this service? So I thank you. And the music, wow, it's just fantastic. Thank you. On behalf of myself, as I said, and Joanna, and our combined families, I want to thank everyone that shared their love, their caring, spent many hours helping out with Joanna when she wasn't feeling well. And I want to acknowledge that today, from the Bay Area to the Bay State, we have people here and on live stream. Got the family from Fresno and from Massachusetts, New Hampshire, New Jersey, Kansas City, people watching from Colorado, from Kingman, Arizona, Phoenix, Arizona, Colorado, you name it. There's lots and lots of people. And as Father mentioned, we've had different gatherings. We had a gathering on Halloween because that was Joanna's favorite holiday. And so I thought, well, you know, you can have many celebrations. So we opened up the gathering to friends and neighbors, and there was a gang of people. And people would say, wow, that's the lady that sat on the porch. So that someone would come by and say, I used to bring my plants and say, well, why weren't they growing? Well, where did you put them? Well, just put them there and water it. Well, that seems a little harsh. Just do it and nurture it, and that plant's gonna grow. So many, many people came by. Then we had a gathering in Fresno for all her family, and the poignant stories that people told that they had never shared before of the impact at critical times in their lives of what Joanna had shared with them. Just incredible. My family, even though living back east, there were many things that Joanna did when she would go back and visit with family. She went back once when I was still plodding away at work, and she spent a month and she rebuilt my father's back porch. Well, my father never saw a woman do something like that. And then my parents would go out for their little day trips to, they always had to visit the local dog up the street. My dad would feed them food. And Joanna had a chance to, I think they had to go to the medical center, and they had had a paratransit ride. And there was a squeaky drawer in the kitchen that my father wasn't quite sure how to fix, and my mother couldn't quite not keep telling him that it needed to be fixed. And so anyway, Joanna had all the tools lined up and had bought everything at the store, and she thought, I have an hour to get this done. Well, she got back, and my father just, you know, was in the kitchen, and the drawer opened up, and he said, how did you do it? She goes, oh, well, it wasn't too difficult, but I had the time, and you didn't. So she was known for doing all those kinds of things. Today, as I said, is honoring Joanna, and it's just wonderful, all the people that she has touched. And I want to say, Joanna was what? She was a devoted daughter of Ruby Marie and Pud. She was a loving sister to Joyce, sister-in-law to DL, and to my sisters and brothers here from back east, great nieces, great nephews all over, cousins all over. She was aunt to sweet Christy, and they said it was okay, and to the boys, John and little Dawn, that are here. Great aunt to Haley, Emily, Alexa, Wilson, niece, friend, stepdaughter Kim, role model, world traveling companion, builder. If people here know that when she worked, lived with three other women, and they bought a house in San Leandro, and it was pretty old. Well, the barn in the back leaned, and the neighborhood came when they saw these four women, and maybe five, I don't know, Marianne, if you helped with it too, straighten out the barn, and it's still straightened out. And they also put in a bottom floor of the house, raised the whole house up, and Gail knows that because she's living in it now and it hasn't come down, so I think it's pretty safe, right? So all of these things that people could do, and as I said, she would give advice on many things, from straightening out a leaning barn to helping you figure out something you had done in life that wasn't quite what you wanted to have done. How do you go forward and change things? She had advice. But her advice was not dictatorial. It was natural. It's like, if you knew something and you could help someone out, why wouldn't you just share it? She didn't ask for praise. She would not have asked for a service. She was not shy, but she didn't like to call attention to herself. But when her sister and I were at the Neptune Society, and I couldn't resist, I needed to have a few extra things. And then the service here, in both in the will and in the notes at the Neptune Society, it said, no, I don't really want any fanfare or service, but if my family needs to do it, let them do it. So that she, you know what I mean? It was that, once again, allowing people to do that which was best for them. In addition to being that world traveling companion and builder, she was a dedicated, respected letter carrier, a union shop steward, and even 2 weeks before she passed, we were getting out of the car after a medical appointment, and this gentleman pulled over, actually stopped in the middle of the road, got out of the car, and came over and said, I gotta hug my shop steward. 20 years earlier, she had saved this job. So I cried a drop of hat. Anyway, she did these things, and then I believe Marilyn had mentioned that, you know, even though she was a shop steward, this was the traditional times when you truly represented your group, but you didn't do it just to antagonize the other side, that she would go to the library and take books out on management because she wanted to know how to best negotiate. And those are all the stories I would hear about her, is that, but she didn't come home and tell me this stuff. She just did it. And the boys know it, you know? She didn't brag about it. So that, to me, was important to acknowledge that. She was a kayaker, rafter, birder par excellence, green thumb gardener, and number one cousin. She was the firstborn. Her mother was one of nine children, and she was the first grandchild, and she was on the pedestal. But she also held that position because she lifted other people up. And as I said, at some of the gatherings, some of the poignant stories that those cousins would say about how their cousin Joanna, Jana, Kinnis, she had many, many names, had made a life change for them. And that's miraculous. She was also the driver of a truck at 5 years old. Her parents worked in the fields. Her mother was originally from Oklahoma and came out this way through the Dust Bowl, you know, because of the Dust Bowl situation. She drove the truck at five, and I remember the story that she said she was this teeny little thing, and she's sitting on the edge of the seat when Marie and Pud had to load things into the truck, and they had her sitting there just to hold it steady, get her little foot on the clutch, so it just putted along. And one time she took her foot off the clutch, and of course the truck just stopped, and her dad was ready to let her know. And mom said, "Pud, look at that big hole." She knew that the truck was gonna go into that hole if she hadn't pulled the foot off the clutch. So she saved them that. So just all the different things that she would do. But she needed to get around too as she got a little older. So at 12 years old, her dad, Pud, said, "Okay, I'm gonna get you a motorcycle. You need to get around, but I'm gonna teach you how to maintain it." So at 12 years old, she was driving a motorcycle. They said, "They'll never believe you're 12, and they'll never believe it's a girl." And so she rode until she was 15, when she got her first ticket, and the local judge said, brought her mother in, and he goes, "Marie," he says, "how old are you?" She said, 15. He said, "You've been driving by my house for years." And she said, "Well," he said, "Marie, I've got to give the ticket to you, because otherwise it'll ruin her getting a license when she's supposed to, but just don't drive in front of my house." So she did the motorcycle for years. So I think that was pretty quite an impactful life. And she used to say, "This little girl from Carruthers, how did she ever meet a little girl from Methuen?" So pretty amazing. We had 33 years together, and 14 of those we had the opportunity to be married. So I'm very, very, it's truly a blessing, truly a great blessing. So they say there are many stories that can be shared, and I hope that people can stay afterwards, because we have some catered goodies from Molly Stone's downstairs. So please, if you have an opportunity, please come down and enjoy that, but also mingle. As you'll learn very quickly, my family and Joanna's family know how to talk. As my mother would say, we have the gift of gab, and right now I'm channeling Ma. We have the gift of gab. So I simply also wanted to just share that Joanna was a gift to everyone who knew her. She gave herself without wanting praise. She wanted to earn your respect, though, and a laugh. She encouraged everyone to live their lives authentically, and she really helped me do that, although I still have more growing to do with that. But being truly authentic, then you can truly give of yourself to others. And so that was, to me, it enabled and empowered people. I'd just like to finish with two things. One other thing that we had in common, besides being hard workers and loving family and wanting to make people feel welcome, is we love poetry. And Joanna loved reading and hearing books on tape when she her eyesight faded away. Her mom was a great poet. And I don't say that lightly. I really consider her the Grandma Moses of poetry, because she wrote poems about stories. They would go on and on and on, and they were incredible. And so I just want to read an excerpt from one of her poems from Ruby Marie Wilson, and it's called "Come Sit With Me." And she wrote it for Joanna. "I can sit each day in my garden plot and thank the Lord for what I've got. The hummingbird just sipped a bit from the little feeder I fixed for it. Flowers grow in my own backyard. My toil is worth it, even when it's hard. I can give my friends a bit of my crop and still be blessed by my garden plot. If you were weary and life seems hard, then sit with me in my backyard. See all the things that I can see alone in my garden when I sit with me." Just beautiful. And I'm gonna tear up on this one. When I was a kid, my grandmother, Nana, that raised us when my parents both were working, our grandfather died when he was 34, and Nana was 32 with six children. And we have a great cousin bond as well because of the core of Nana, Mary Etta Callahan Slack. And she always told me about this little phrase that was given to her in a sympathy card. This is from 1925. So, and it says, "There must be dark, cold weather and winds and rain so wild. Not all good things together come to us here, my child. So when some deep joy loses its beauteous summer glow, think how the roots of the roses are kept alive in the snow." Amen.
Thank you, Carol. Beautiful. Thank you. Yes, there's so much love to share, so many stories to be told. And there is an opportunity for exactly that to happen immediately following our Mass, so right downstairs. Bye-bye, friends. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. Let us take a moment as we remember and are mindful of the goodness of God. My bad. Home is where the heart is. Joanna, Irene, Kennedy will always have a home in the hearts of those who love and remember. Joanna, Irene, Kennedy will always have a home in that place in heaven, a place prepared for her, a place being prepared for all of us. My friends, before we go our separate ways, we take leave of our sister, Joanna. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness. May it strengthen us in hope. For one day, We believe this one day we shall joyfully greet her again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace. Amen. May her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. And into your hands, O Father of mercies, we commend our sister Joanna, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks, O Lord, for the blessings which you bestowed upon Joanna in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. And so we ask, merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant Joanna, and help us who remain to comfort each other with assurances of faith and hope and love until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever and ever. Amen. My dear friends, again, thank you. It is such an honor and a privilege to welcome you into this very special place. A place where God's inclusive love is proclaimed and where we never stop trying to live that love. And thank you so much for being here to show your love and support for Joanna, for Carol, for her family, for all those who will miss her presence in life. We are mindful, yes, of the ways we are called to bless each other. And so as we prepare to depart from this place of prayer, and to go to a place that Joanna would love, a place of hospitality, a place of sharing food, sharing stories, sharing laughter. And yes, with Carol, I'm sure there will be a few more than a few tears. But we share because, well, that's what Joanna would want us to do, and we do it well. So my friends, let us stand. Blessing. Just say your word. No. Don't you say bow down and pray for God's blessing? Is that your word? So Jim is a deacon. He's a good friend of Carol. He's only been a deacon for a short while. No, deacons don't have that many lines. And I stumbled over. I tripped on one of his lines. So I'm trying to be sure he gets his lines. So Jim's word was, let us pray for God's blessing. Gracious and loving God, we give you thanks. We are so blessed in so many ways. Today we are grateful for the blessing that is and always will be Joanna, Irene, Kennedy. We are grateful for the many ways you bless us and call us to love. And so we ask you to bless her now, bless her always, and let that blessing descend upon each one of us, Father, Son, Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thanks be to God. Thanks be to God. Thanks be to God. Thanks be to God. And thank you everyone for joining us. Thank you, Carol. I love you so much. We all love you. We love your dear sister. Let us raise our voices in song.
When all the world is a hopeless jumble and the raindrops tumble all around, heaven opens a magic day. When all the clouds darken up the skyway, there's a rainbow highway to be found, leading from your window behind the sun, just a step beyond the rain, somewhere and why can't I?
Okay.